Hello and welcome to part 6 on how to create the Reddit UI with React.js. In this part, I will show you how to create the post body. I am going to add a title, an image and a description to the post. So let's get started right away. So we left off at adding the image and the title and the description to our Reddit post. So I'm going to start with adding the title to our Reddit post. Right now, the Reddit post has a blue background and an S in it, and we're going to change that. So I'm gonna go into the landing, and it was the content. Then we had the posts, and right here we have our post. So here we are mapping the posts. And somewhere right here is the post body. So this will be the body. And then I'm going to save it up, and when it is saved, the page will refresh. And as we can see, the body is being displayed right here. So that is working already. What I want to do then is I want to add the title to the body. So instead of rendering the body, I want to render the post.title. So the title is a variable inside our post. And right now we see all the titles of our post. And if I'm going to take the post right here, we can see that we have a title, a first comment, subreddit, username, and some posts have a image source and some have a description. So I'm first going to focus on the title, and the title will be a lot bigger and a little bit boldish. So I'm also going to change the blue background color of our post, so this won't be blue. Let's see where we put it. Right here, post body background color is gone, like this. And then I want to target the title. So let's see, this has the title right here, and I'm going to give it a span like so, and the class name will be title, because it's the title of the post body. So then I'm going to go into my post body. Let's see, there's a footer, here we have the title, so in between those, post wrapper, post body, and then the dot title, font size of 80 pixels, maybe 21. So I don't think that I'm targeting it correctly. So let's see, we have our post wrapper, posts wrapper. Ah, okay, so I missed the S. Yes. So 21 is maybe too big. I'm going to reduce it to 18. Yes. And I want to make the font weight a little bit more bold. So 500, which we don't have. 600. Yes. So right now we have a little bold title. And then we want to add a margin left. And I think we want to align it with the title section of the post. So the title section, which is right here, has an image. So I'm going to go and look at how we did that. We gave the image a margin of 5 pixels. So that is 5 pixels from the left. So I'm going to give this a margin left of 5 pixels as well. So right here, margin left of 5 pixels, like so. And then our text is aligned with the image. So what I want to do next is I want to add the image when we have one. So I'm going to make that optional, and how I'm going to do it is like this. I'm going to say post dot image source. If we have that, then we want to display an image like so, and the source will be post dot image source. So let's see. Okay, good. So now when we have an image, we will display it. And when we don't have an image, like for example right here at the snacks, we are not displaying anything. So that is working correctly, but now I want to limit the image's width to the post. So I think I'm going to do that by adding a max width to it. So this image right here will have a width of 100%. Okay, no, so 100% is not working. So let's see, how are we going to crop our images to that format. I think I'm going to give it a max width, and then I'm going to make the height automatically fill the height of the post. So let's see, right here we have the image post body. Okay, so I'm going to target the post wrapper post body, and I'm going to target the image, and I want to say let's see, I want to give it the same width as the post. So the post has let's see, I don't think I gave a fixed width to the post. Okay, so that's okay. Width 100% didn't work, I think. Okay, so width 100% does work, but as you can see, our height is also working, but our image is being cropped off, because if we look at the original image, oh well, it doesn't even crop something off. It just, no, I think it already works, but I want to limit the image height. And to do that, I'm going to say max height of, let's say, 500 pixels, because we don't want our images to be too big. So then it appears like this. But what we are getting right now is, I want to make it even smaller, I think, 400 pixels. 500 is fine. What is happening right now is that our image is getting a little bit distorted, because we are using not the correct ratio for the width and height. So if I say, let's see, position, object, fit, and then cover, then it will cover the object, and I'm going to also say object position of center, so it will be centered inside of our post. So by applying this, we will see that the image is not longer being distorted, but some part of the image might get cut off, but that's okay, since we can view the whole image if we click on the post. So I'm going to add those two classes to the image, and I'm going to do that right here. I want to first specify the height, and I want to say above here, object fit cover, and then object position center, like so. So now we have our images being displayed, and let's see. No, the spacing between the text and the images is okay. So let's see what we still have. We also have, except for an image, we also have a description. So for example, this post and this post, if we look in our data, has a description. So the first one doesn't have a description, but the one about the snacks does have a description. What was your best and biggest snack? So let's see, I'm going to add that to here. And right here, I'm going to look for an example of a description. So right here we have a description, we have the title, and then in small letters we have the description underneath it. So in my body, I'm going to add a new span, and it will be optional because I only want to render it if we have the description. So I'm going to do the same as with the image, and then I want to say that I want to render the post.description, like so. And if I save this up, we will see our description appearing, but it is appearing right after our snacks. So that is not what we want. So to fix this, I'm going to add a break to it as well. And instead of using a break right here, I think I'm going to make the span with the description a block element. So right now it is an inline element. And if I say display block, yes, it will display beneath our title. So that's actually what I'm trying to achieve. And I'm going to give this a class name of description, like so. And I'm going to target the description right here. Description. I'm going to say margin left of 5 pixels and a display of block, like so. Okay. And then I want to have a little bit of spacing between the title and the description. So I don't want the spacing between the title and the image, but I do want it between the title and the description. So I'm not going to add the margin to the title, but instead I'm going to add it to the description. So I'm going to say margin top of 10 pixels, something like that. And then I want to make the text a little bit smaller, I think. No, I think this is fine. Yeah. So now we have the description appearing here as well. And we have created three different types of posts. We have a post with only a title, right here. We have the post with a title and an image. And we have the post with a title and a description. So, good job. So on the Reddit page, we also have a fourth element, which is a video post. And I don't actually have the video post in our post.json. So I'm going to create a new post up above our last post. And I'm going to copy over the contents from, let's see, this post right here. I'm going to paste them in here. And then I want to say that we don't have an image source, but a video source. And it will be assets videos and then penguins.mp4. And the title will be penguin, like so. Let's see, and the username I will keep the same for the comments as well. So if I look at the Reddit page right now, we will see that we have a post with penguin, but we actually want to have our video being rendered right there. So I'm going to say that when we have a video, which is right here, I'm going to put it above here, post.video source. Then I want to render a video element, which will be video. And let's see, we have in the video a source, which will be post.video source, like so. And if I save this up and refresh the page, we will see our video appearing. But as with the image, our video is far too big. So I'm going to fix that first. Let's see, we have here our image. And I'm just going to copy over this. And instead of image, it will be video. And I'm going to give it a width of 100%, like so. So now it is nicely cropped. And if we click on the video, nothing will happen. And we actually don't even see the controls of the video. So I'm going to look into the video tag. And maybe if we add controls and refresh the page, yes, then we will see the controls. So right now we have a video being played and rendered right here, and we can pause it as well. But with the Reddit page, we have a different video player. So instead of those controls, we have those controls. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a separate component for our video element, and I'm going to map every control which we are using right here to the video controller. So inside my components, I'm going to create a new component, which will be video. And in a video component, I'm going to create a video.tsx and a video.css, like so. Right here, I'm going to import React. Import, and then I'm going to export the function, and we have the video right here. And I'm going to, instead of applying this, I'm going to use our own video, which is this one. And if I refresh the page, we will see nothing, because let's see, we didn't import it yet, I think. So I thought it automatically imported it. So right now we have imported it from here. And if I refresh the page, we'll see our video appearing. But then I want to, let's see, give it the video tag as well. So instead of rendering this div, I'm going to render the video. And a video will get a post as a source. So I'm going to say interface props source, which will be a string. And right here we have a source of type props. And I'm going to use the source right here. And then we have to pass the source into our video, which will be post.video source, like so. So now we have the video source right here. We pass it to our video. Then it accepts it right here as a property, and the property will be passed onto our element. And as you can see, it's working. And then I want to, instead of styling our video right here, I want to style it right here. So I'm going to give this an ID of video player. And then I'm going to remove the controls, since we are going to implement them by ourselves. So I'm going to wrap this video in a div, like so. And then I'm going to create the video controls right here. And I'm going to create a wrapper for them. So I'm going to create a div with an ID of video controls. And then let's see, we have a logo of Reddit, so that will be an image. and then we will have a button. So we have the play button. Then we have the text of how many seconds we are into the video, a bar, and the text of how long the video is going to take. So position, then we have the bar input, which will be of type slider, and I think I have to say type equals slider, like so. Then we have the span with the duration. Then we have a cog, a full screen button, and the sound button. So I'm going to create three more buttons: the cog, full screen, and sound. FS for simplicity, and sound. And I'm actually going to create the Reddit logo inside of a button as well, since we want to be able to click on the Reddit logo. So right here, I'm going to insert the image, which will be a logo. So now we have the basics of our video down, but it is not working as expected. And as you can see, the video is really big again. So I'm going to remove the video styling from our post, and I'm going to add it to our video right here. I'm going to say that we have our video player, and it will have a width of 100%, like so. And then we see all our controls at the bottom, and this one has to be a slider, but it isn't appearing as a slider. So to make it appear as a slider, I'm going to have to apply the type of range instead of slider, so it will look like this. And now we have a nice little ranged position. Okay, good. So the next thing I want to do is I want to move this inside of our video and remove the controls. So removing controls actually really easy, just removing controls, and we have a bare video. And then I want to move this into our video player by positioning it absolute, I think. So I'm going to give this an ID as well. It will be video container, and right here I'm going to target our video controls, like so. Video controls, yes. And then I want to position an absolute. Position absolute, and then I want to position our, let's see, video container relative, like so. And then I want to give the video controls a bottom of 0 pixels, like so. And then maybe increase that to 5 pixels or even 10 pixels. Let's see, I think 25 is maybe better. Yeah, so 25 is good, I think. And then I want to center them horizontally, so I want to make them even as wide as the video player, and then divide all the children over the width of the video player. So let's see, we have our controls. I want a width of 100%. Does it work? Yes, so now it's even as wide as the video player. Display of flex, yes. And then we can say justify content space between, something like this. Yes, okay. So that's what I'm going to add. I'm going to say to our video controls, width of 100%, a display of flex, like so, and then a justify content of space between, like so. And then I'm going to remove those buttons, and I'm going to replace them with our icons. So the icons that I will be using, I'm going to import right now. I'm going to import, let's see, we have the play arrow icon from material icons, play arrow right here. The next one will be the settings icon. Oh, so I'm going to copy this settings icon from settings. Then we have the full screen icon. Full screen, let's see, like so. Then we have the sound icon, import volume off from material UI icon slash volume, and it is volume mute or volume off, one of those two. So I'm going to import the play arrow icon right here, and let's see what it will do. we can see the arrow icon appearing, and I actually don't want it right here. I want it in our play button, which is right here. And I think the icon looks really good already. And now we want to do the cog, which will be the cog right here. And that one is the settings icon, like so. Full screen. Full screen icon. Up, like so. And then the volume off icon. Like so. And full screen is with a small S. So I think those are the icons that we want to use, and we can see them right here. They are not exactly the same, but they are doing fine, I think. So next up, I want to style the buttons, because we don't want to actually render a button-like element, but we want to render the icon. So I'm going to say background of none, and a border of none, and a color of white. Yes. So now we see our icon appearing white, and yes, if you click on it, we also see a border. I don't want that. So let's see. I'm going to add to our button a class, which will be, let's see, button. And then I'm going to use this right here as well. So I'm also actually going to say video button. I want to use it for the settings as well, full screen and the volume off. And then I can style it by that. So I'm going to say hashtag video controls video button background none border none and then color of white, like so. So now all our buttons are being white, and when we click on a button, we still see the border. I actually don't want that to happen. So let's see which class is being applied right then. And I cannot find the element in our element inspector, but I've looked it up, and it is the outline element. So outline will be none, like so. And then when we click on a button, we won't see the outline anymore, but we see that our icon is moving a little bit to the right. So I'm also going to say padding of 0 pixels. So now our buttons aren't moving anymore. And I actually want to create a little bit of gradient on the background of our inputs, so we can actually see our inputs on the white video. So before I'm going to do that, I'm going to first replace the logo with our actual logo. And to do that, I'm going to go right here, and I'm going to remove this with our image source equals assets images Reddit. And then it was a Reddit logo. Let's see. Reddit lowercase logo, or lower stripe logo.jpg, and then a backslash, like so. And then I want to also apply the class which we had on the video button, so we won't see the border and the background and everything, like so. And then I want to make the logo a lot smaller, so I'm going to say that we want to give this a class name of Reddit logo, and then in my video.css, in the video controls, we have a video button with a Reddit logo, and I wanted to have a max width of 16 pixels and a max height of 16 pixels. And I'm first going to specify the height and then the width, like so. Well, that's way too big still. I think, yes, I wrote something wrong. For the rest, it looks good. And I want to make it 32 pixels, I think. Like so. Yes. Well, maybe that's too big, actually. 24. Yes. Okay, that looks better. And then I want to apply a gradient border to our div. So let's see. We have our div right here. We have the video controls. And then I want to give them a bottom of 25 pixels. And then a padding bottom of also 25 pixels. And I'm going to say bottom 0 pixels, like so. And what I want to do then is I want to add a linear gradient. And I have to do it by specifying a background of linear gradient. And then I can specify which values I'm going to pass. So I'm going to say to top. And I want to transition from, let's see, black to transparent, like so. And that actually looks already really good, but I think it is too black at the bottom. So let's see, we are first going to remove our bottom, and we're going to replace it with a padding bottom of 25 pixels, like so. And then on our video controls, I'm going to apply a linear gradient. So right here we have a background linear gradient, like rooftop from RGBA or RGB 0, yes, 0, 0, 0. And then to transparent, so like this, but it isn't, oh wait, we still have to add the bottom, but then we have to say bottom 0 pixels, like so. Okay, but I don't want it to be that big, the linear gradient, so I wanted to smooth a little bit out more. So to do that, I'm actually going to use alpha, and I'm going to say 0.5, like so, and I'm going to decrease it to 0.2, maybe to 0.8, and let's see, 0.7, yes, okay, so 0.7 looks good, I think, maybe even 0.6, yes, so it's just that we have a little bit of gradient on our, let's see, on our controls. But one thing I'm noticing is that our margin at the bottom, or our padding, is beyond our video, I think. So we have the video container with the video. Yes, so I think the video has a little bit of margin at the bottom. So to fix this little thing at the bottom, I'm going to apply a display of block to my video, and then we will display our video as a block element, which will remove the border at the bottom. So let's see, our video player will have a display of block, like so, and then we can see that the linear gradient nicely smooths into our video. I actually want to remove this, or decrease this to 15 pixels, like so, and then I want to start working on the layout of the controls. So I want them to be a little bit spaced out from the sides. So instead of space between, I'm going to say space around, like so. And then I'm going to, let's see. Yes, when we hover over it, I want them to appear. And when we hover not over them, I want them to disappear. So let's see. Every video button will have a class. And then when we hover over it, that class will become visible. And when we not hover over it, the class will not be visible. So this will be a hover button, and I'm actually going to turn it around. I'm going to say the volume button always is present. So I'm going to say always present right here. And then I want to say that we want to target the video controls. And then the video button always present. I'm going to prefix it with video button, like so. And this will get an opacity of 1, like so. Oh, this is not a good one, like so. And then the rest will have an opacity of 0, like so. And then when we hover over it, I want to make them appear. So let's see, when we hover over our video, which is the video player, then I want to target the controls. So that's good because we can use the plus selector. So video player is right here. And then I want to target the video controls and then the video button. And I want to give it an opacity of 1. So that is already working. I now want to apply it to the position, the duration, and the slider as well. So I'm going to add, I think, a separate element for it. I'm going to keep this as always present. And I'm actually going to replace this with control, always present, video control. And then I can apply the video control to here as well. Right here, to the span as well, to the input as well, to the span as well, the button as well, and then our button right here. And I want to put it behind the video button, like so. And I can remove the opacity zero on our button, and I can remove this and replace this with control button. And then I want to target the control button and want to say opacity of zero. Okay, so right now, let's see, I think I wrote something wrong. Control button, control, oh, video control it is. Video control, video control, like so. So now this one is always visible, and when we hover over it, we will see that the rest is becoming visible as well. Except for the slider and the two spans. So I don't know why that is not working. Video control. So I think I have to, yes, I have to change it right here as well. So I still had video button. So right now we can see everything becoming visible. And then I want to transition it nicely, so we can see a transition smoothly inside of the field. And I'm going to say that by transition opacity 200 ms and then linear, like so. And then we can see a nice little transition, and maybe that's even too slow. So I'm going to make it a little bit faster. And I actually also want to transition the gradient. So when we don't hover over the video, I don't want the gradient. And when we do hover over the video, I want to display the gradient. So by default it will have no background, like so. And then let's see, when we hover over the video player, and then I want to target the video controls, I'm going to give it a background, like so. And then I want to give that a transition as well. So right here I'm going to say transition background, and then with 100 ms linear, like so. And then we will see our background not transitioning, I think. So the background element doesn't support a transition, but what I can do is I can change the opacity from 0 to 1 on the background. So I want to always have this actually, but I want to have it a opacity of 0, like so. And then when we hover over it, I want to give it an opacity of 1, like so. And then we will see our background appearing. And I want to also give it a transition. So it will be right here, transition. And then it will be the opacity, 100 ms, and then linear, like so. And now the linear gradient also transitions nicely. But our, let's see, our mute button is disappearing as well. So that is actually not something that I want, but that is because I added the opacity of 0 to our video controls. So right here we have our always present, but it is being ignored because the overlaying element is not displaying. So to fix this, I'm going to add a different component for our linear gradient. So in the video I'm going to say that we have a div with a class name of video controls background, like so. And then let's see, if I open up the page right now, we will see our div appearing, I think. And I'm going to look in how this div is being styled. It has zero width and let's see, zero nothing. So I'm going to position the absolute, that's the first thing. Then I want to give it a width of 100%, or I even want to give it a, let's see, top of 0 pixels, right of 0 pixels, bottom of 0 pixels, and a left of 0 pixels. Then we have this. Okay, good. So this is actually what I want. So now I can use this as the linear gradient. Inside the video controls, video controls, we have our video controls background, and then I want to give it those values, position absolute, And I can't copy those over, I think, or I can. No. Okay, so top 0 pixels, right 0 pixels, bottom 0 pixels, and left of 0 pixels. Okay. And then I want to apply the linear gradient to that one. So the background right here, maybe this. And now we see it. I want to remove the opacity from this one and the transition as well. So then we end up with this. I want to now apply this to our background. And then I want to change our background when we hover over it. So plus video controls. So I want to select this one, but also the, let's see, hashtag video controls, and then the dot video controls background. I both want to give them opacity of 1, and then we have the desired effect. And I think it's working nicely, but the background is now overlaying on our elements, which is not what I actually want. So to fix that, I'm going to, let's say, go into the video controls, and I want to give this a C index of 1, I think. And I want to give the rest of the video controls a Z index of 2, like so. So now they appear over our gradient layer. But right here we have a different video control. Video control always present. And if we give that a Z index of 2 as well, we will see that it is also appearing on top of our gradient. Okay, good. So let's see. We have our video controls right here, cindex 2, cindex 2. And I don't think that I even have to specify the one. Yes, so this is working already. But when we hover over the video, it works. But when we hover over the controls, it is not working anymore. So to fix this, I'm going to apply the hover on our video container. So I'm going to say video container hover, and I'm going to select the video controls by using the chart selector instead of the plus selector, like so. And then we can hover over our controls. So that is working correctly. Next, I want to make every button that we have a mouse button, so that when we hover over it we see a pointer appearing. So let's see, every button has a class name of video button, and the video button is right here, and I want to give it a cursor of pointer. So now when we hover over a button, let's deselect this, we will see a pointer appearing, so that's good. And then I want to work on the biggest part, which is the slider, and then we're going to make the slider move accordingly to our video location. So I'm going to create a value in our video.tsx. I'm going to use a state, and let's say const. And then we have the time, set time is use state, and then we are at 0 at the beginning. And I'm going to import this from React. And then I want to, let's see, display the time on the left and the right. So I'm also going to display the video duration. And I know that the video takes 7 seconds of duration. So normally you'd get that from the API which you are getting the video from, but right now I'm going to edit it right here. I'm going to say duration, which will be 7, which is in seconds. And then I can say right here that we get a source and a duration, which will be a number. And then I can pass it from the post to our component, duration equals post.duration. And then I also have to add it to our model, which is right here. And then we have a, we didn't even add the video. So video source, which is a string, and then a duration, which is a number, like so. And then I can go ahead and use this duration right here. And then right here, I want to say 0, I think. Type string is not assignable to number. Okay, so this is a number, and right here we are posting in a string. So why is that not possible? We have to specify this as a number. Okay. So right now it should be working. Yes. And we see the duration and the beginning time. And I actually want to make those two white so we can actually see them better. So let's see, in our video.css, I want to apply a color to the video controls, which will be white, like so. And next I want to specify or modify the look of our duration bar or the slider. So I'm first going to align everything to the center. So I'm going to go ahead and say align items center, like so. And then I'm going to make the play button clickable so that it will play the video. And then when we click on the play button, it will change into a pause button. So I'm actually going to import that one as well. So we have a play arrow icon. We also have a pause icon. Material UI icons / and then pause icon or just pause, like so. And then I'm going to create a new state variable, which will be playing, set playing, and it will default to false. So when we click on this button, let's see, where is it? Right here. When you click on this button, I want to change the state of our playing. So I want to onClick equals, and then we get an event, and then we're going to say set playing, and I'm going to say that we get the value, and we want the value to be the opposite of the value. So I'm going to hook up our play value. I'm going to say use effect. And then I want to say that I have a function which takes as parameter right here the playing variable, and I want to console.log for playing state right here. So if I open up the console and I click on the play button, let's see, we get a true, false, true, false, true, false. Okay, so that's working. Next I want to apply the play state to the video player. So instead of console.logging, I'm going to say const video equals document.getElementById, which will be video player. And then if video, I want to say video.play. And I actually cannot say play, I think. So why is that not? So I think I have to cast this to an HTML video element, and then I can call the function play. Yes, okay. So now we will always play the video when we click on it. And I actually also have to say that it can be null. Alright, I can actually cast this as an HTML video element, because we are sure that we will get this because it is an ID. So if I save this up and click on play, we should see our video starting. Yes, okay. And when you click on it again, it will play again, but we don't want that. We want to say if video, let's see, if playing, then we want to say video dot pause, because if we are playing the video, we want to pause it, and else we want to say video dot play, like so. And then when you click on it, it will play. And then we click again, it will pause. Okay, so that's working. And I don't know if I did this correctly. If it is, okay, so if it is playing, I want to pause it. Okay, good. Yes. And now I want to change the play icon with a pause icon. So I'm going to do it with a inline if statement. And I'm going to set it right here. Instead of the play icon, I want to display the other icon. So let's see, we have is playing. Oh, and we just named it playing. If it is playing, then display the play arrow. If it is playing, display the pause icon. If it is not playing, display the arrow icon, like so. And if I save this up, we will see the play. And yes, then it will transform into the pause button. But the state is not working correctly the first time. Okay, so yeah, the reason why that is because when we first load the page, playing will be false. And when we click on this button, we set playing to true. So then we want to play. But if we look at here, we see that we have our playing statement. And if we click on it the first time, it is true. So we set playing to true, but then we pause the video. So we actually want to switch this. And once if we are not playing the video, we want to pause it. If we do want to stop the video, we want to pause it. If we are going to play the video, we want to play it. So that's why it was not starting before. So now if I click on play, it starts. And if I click on pause, it pauses. So that's working correctly already. Next, I want to update the span right here, and I want to update the slider. So for the value right here, I'm going to use a time value actually. And I think that I want to use a reference instead of a state. So const time equals use ref right here. And I want to set it to 0. And I think we still, okay, we imported it already. So what I want to do is when we load the document, so use effect, and then we want to pass in a empty array, like so. When we load the document, we want to subscribe to our video. So we want to say const video equals document dot get element by ID video player as HTML video element. And then I want to listen for any changes. So I'm going to say view dot add event listener, and then I want to listen to the change event, and then I want to console.log which value we are getting. So I'm going to console.log the E. And if I open up the console and I click on play, we see nothing. Okay, so that's working great. So okay, yeah, it is not a change, but the time update value. So let's see, time update, and I want to console.log the value of the event. So if I open up the browser right now and I click on play, we will see that once it will allow me. Okay, so I don't think that I can just say e.value. So when I refresh the page, we will see that we are getting a couple of values, and when I pause the video, it will stop console.logging them. So let's see, right here we can see what timestamp we are, which is right here. So this timestamp is what I'm going to use for the time updating function. So I'm going to set e.timestamp, and then I want to let's see, update the time with that. So I'm going to say time dot current and then equals timestamp, like so, and then I can remove it like so. And it cannot find the name timestamp, that's because it is of the event. So right now our time is being updated, and then when we update our time, I want to also update our slider. So I'm going to say use effect, and then I want to pass in as a value the time, which is our reference. And now we get a notification from every time we update the time. Every time we update the time, yeah. So if I click on play right now, we are not firing actually the use effect. So now that we have our current time, I want to update the slider with that value. So I'm going to say const slider equals document get element by ID, and it will be the let's see, where do we have the slider? Right here, our video control, and I'm going to give it an ID of video slider. Video slider, like so, and it will be a HTML input element, like so. And I want to say slider dot value equals time dot current, like so. So the slider value actually needs a string as input, and I'm actually going to say that we want to use the timestamp, I think. So I'm going to change this with this right here, and then it will accept the value. But as we can see, the slider is immediately moving to the right. So I'm going to adjust how we calculate the time. So the time will be the video dot duration divided by 100, and then times the timestamp of the video. And if I use this, we will get the value of the slider, which is relative. But as you can see, it's still not updating correctly. That is because I'm using a timestamp. If I use the let's see, video dot current time, then I think I'm getting the time in milliseconds instead of the timestamp, and I actually have to switch up the 100 and the video duration, like so. So now we get on a scale of 100 times the current time, so this will be like 50% or 60%, and if I play it, you can see the slider moves accordingly to the video. So that's working correctly. What I want to finish off with is I want to make that when we click on the slider, we reposition in the video. And I also want to make this text update. So the text update will be doing as follows. I'm going to target the text right here. So our text will have an ID, which is this one. ID equals, or maybe I'm not even going to give it an ID. Okay, so instead of using a ref, I think I'm going to go with a state again. Time set time equals use state 0, and then right here I won't be displaying the time current, and I'm going to say let time equals that, and here we have time, and then I want to say set time, and I want to set the time to our video dot current time, like so. And then I want to use the time right here. So I think by making it a state again and updating it right here, we will get our updated time, yes, in our span. But it is actually showing really far behind the comma. So I think I'm going to make it so that it rounds up, or well, it rounds to the nearest number. Met.round, and then I'm going to met.round the video current time. So if I play it right now, yes, we will see the video time being displayed right here, and it will slowly count up to 7, like so. And then I want to, when we click on the slider, move the video in time. So I'm going to listen to the slider. I'm going to do that right here. I'm going to say const, and then actually I'm going to get the slider right above here. And I'm going to say slider dot add event listener, and then I'm going to listen for a change, and I'm going to target the event, and then I want to console dot log the event. So let's see what we get from that. Okay, so right now we are not getting anything, and if I slide it, we see that we get an event update. But I think, okay, so if we play it, we don't get an event update, only if we click on it. So that's actually really good. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to, let's see, get the value from our slider. So I'm going to say console.log slider.value. So we should actually get the correct value of our slider. Let's see, now we have a 24, 69, 94, 33. Okay, good. And then I want to map it to the video time. So actually, I want to do this, but then in reverse. So we have let slider value equals slider dot value. And then I'm going to say let time equals. We now have the time, so I'm going to say slider value, which is the time. And instead of doing this, I want to say that I want the current time. So what is the current time? The current time is time divided by the video duration. So let's say slider value divided by 100 divided by the video dot duration. So I think this will work out. And then I want to say video dot current time equals time. So right here it says that it is not a number, so I'm going to change it by specifying it as a number, and then it will parse the value as a number. And I'm also going to add a parse int right here. So it will parse the integer of our slider value. So if I save this up and refresh the page and I click on the slider, we will see the video moving. So that looks actually really cool. And we can move the video all around. And we can click on play again and it works. So this looks really cool actually. So I think I'm going to leave this for now as it is. We have created a simple video player which has a control bar at the bottom. We are displaying the current time, we are displaying the final time. We have created the different buttons which don't work right now, but we do have them, and we have the Reddit logo at the bottom left. We can also navigate through our video with the slider, and we can click on play and we can pause the video. So we have created three different kinds of Reddit posts, one with an image, one with text, and one with the video. And I'm really happy on how it turned out. And I think it's really cool that we created our own little video editor or video player. And I think I'm going to create a separate video on how to fully customize the HTML5 video player with full screen, with music or sounds and settings. So subscribe to stay tuned, leave a like and comment down below, and I'll see you next time. Bye.